sorry. We are returned. This is another one of Chris's vacation beers. Howe Sound Rockfish Red Ale. It has a whole big ass write up on what rockfish are and how they're awesome. And $1 from the sale of ale supports Canadian Parks and Wilderness Society. So there you go.
It's kind of funny because it says on there, it says beer for animals.
Yes.
So when I first bought it, I was like,
does it taste like animals?
Are we supposed to drink this or should I give it to my dog? Or?
Yes.
But yeah, we're going to drink it.
Rockfish.
You probably won't be able to find this because I think it's a special limited edition something.
That's possible.
But if you can find it.
Is it supposed to be a red ale?
Looks like.
Kind of a brownish red?
Dark red?
Don't know.
Smells quite nice.
And of course the best part of the show is that. Oops.
Very creamy.
Whoa.
Smells a little wee bit chocolatey.
Smells familiar. Smells a lot like probably some other things that they've done.
The rail ale, maybe?
Yeah, it could be. I think I got a lot of foam.
It's quite passable.
Yeah.
I'm liking it.
It's got a kind of a sweet up front with a kind of a bitter tingle that goes away pretty fast and it got more sweet.
It's fairly, a malty. I would say that even the flavor is reminiscent of the rail ale that make.
Shh.
Yeah.
Cat's driving me insane.
The brown ale.
The brown ale.
That they make, but it doesn't quite have the same amount of nuttiness or something to it.
True.
I don't know what else to say about this.
Not much, yeah.
It's sort of run of the mill.
Yeah.
But, like, good.
Yeah, I would say so. If you have to have an. If, as far as Howe Sound goes, if this is average, you're doing pretty good.
Yeah.
Indeed. Have you ever heard anything out of Dave? Did he try that St. Ambrose?
Yeah, he didn't like it.
What a pussy.
My brother-in-law, we left him the St. Ambrose oatmeal stout.
And let's preface this by saying he only drinks pea water. Like, he drinks Bud and that's it.
And Red Stripe.
And Red Stripe, yeah, but that's he's tropical, so.
It's all around,
yeah.
There's
it's
not
good.
Too much to say. It's quite, yeah. It's tasty. It's unfortunate they're not going to make more of it.
Yeah, well, I've seen them put out red ales, a couple of different red ales, but I think they might be the same ale with a different label.
It's possible.
I haven't tried them, so I can't say yes or no.
A special one to make some money for something.
They had Wandering the Winter Boomer's Red Ale, which, like, I think every bottle you buy, a dollar went to this guy's family, this hockey player Boomer that had died. What else was there? Isn't there one that has beavers on it?
Yeah. I can't remember what that one's called. Something beaver.
Yeah, three beavers, something. I don't know. Yeah, so I don't know. I'll give this one a button. Six and a half?
I'd give it a seven.
Yeah.
It's above average, but
mm-hmm.
not exceeding average.
Yeah.
Or exceeding above average. It's not excellent. Not quite as good as their rail ale, which I gave a 10, because it's amazing, and I still buy it, and I love it. I've yet to meet anything that was good.
Oh, my aunt and uncle were over.
Yeah.
And my aunt's was leaving the house, and she looks over, and I've got all the empties in a box. And she's like, well, do you have enough, Cattleman's barbecue sauce? I'm like, that's not barbecue sauce. Well, what is it? That is beer. Or it was beer. And I think that's all we have to say about any of that stuff.
Yeah, it's
Let's break out the whiskey. Peace out.